Hi there, this is Unmesh from PixImperfect, and today I'm going to show you a really interesting way to create Photoshop templates using the brand new PSDT file format. It's not exactly brand new, it was introduced with Photoshop CC 2017. So what is the big deal with PSDT? Why was it introduced and why do we need to use it? Well, the PSDT or Photoshop Document Template file format was created to solve the biggest issue we had with Photoshop templates. So first of all, we need to understand the problem with them. Only then we can understand the usage of PSDT. It's amazing. So here we are in our file explorer, and I've made a template for Instagram post high resolution, and have a look at it. It is in PSD format, not PSDT, right? Now, if I open that up, let's double click on it. Let's open that up. And now have a look at the template. It's pretty nice, and it's about AskPix live and the timing. So every time I post something, I can change any of the text, I can change the timing, and I can also change the image. So this is a nice template. So usually what we used to do, we used to just play with this original template. So we used to maybe I want to replace the image, I used to delete it, and then maybe let's just drag and drop in some other image. Just drag it and drop it inside here, and then adjust it probably, and then clip it to this rectangle. So we are just changing stuff, we are adjusting stuff, and we are modifying the original template, the original file. So let's say we change the background to, you know, something like this, hit OK, and then we change the text. And now what we have to do, we have to go to File, and then Save As. If you accidentally click on Save, the original template file will be affected. It was dangerous. So anytime I'm working on a project, I'm used to pressing Ctrl or Command S and keep on saving it. But that is going to affect the original file. It's going to make a change to the original file. So let's say I was making a change here. I made all this change and I accidentally pressed Ctrl or Command S, and have a look at it. Now, if I open up the template is changed. It's changed. Let's reopen it. We did not want that. To prevent that, what we used to do, we used to go to, let's say we made a change right here to the color and we changed to green, and we had to go to File, and then instead of Save, Save As, and then save it as a different name like this, Save, hit OK, and that was that. It's risky. Instead of doing all this, all you have to do is this. First of all, let's close all of this. We don't want to save any of the changes. You have to do this. Have a look. This is PSD file, right? Let's delete this extra. You need to right click on it and choose Rename, and change the file name from PSD to PSDT. Just add T to it and hit Enter or Return. Are you sure you want to change it? Yes. If you do not see .psd, and if you're on Windows, all you need to do, you need to unhide the extension. So if you're not seeing extensions like JPEG or PSD or whatever that is, you need to go to Folder Options. So inside of View here, you will have to go to Options. Just click on Options, and here, View tab, just make sure this is unchecked. Hide extensions for known file types. Make sure this is unchecked, apply it, and then hit OK in case you're not seeing them. Now what happens is, when you double click on it and open it, every time you open it, a new document is going to show up. Have a look, Untitled 1. And it's not going to affect the original template. So no matter what changes you make, right, I make it black, something like this, and hit OK, and then if I press Ctrl or Command S, it's going to open up the dialog box asking you to save with a new file name. It's amazing. So let's say I, you know, change the color right here to something else, let's say red, and maybe move the image a little bit, or changed the image, changed the text here and there, and I can just save this version, right, get done with it. I don't want to save it now. And the next time you open up the template, a new document will show up. No change was made. So now you can add some other image. Let's say I delete this image, and let's say I add some other image. So I go to my stock folder, and I'm going to drop in this image. So drag it, and inside of Photoshop, I'm going to drop it right there, and hit Enter or Return. Now put it above the rectangle, and just clip it in just right there. And I changed the image, I changed a lot of things, let's say. And then when I save it, Ctrl or Command S, it will ask you to save with a different name. So let's save it as version 1. Hit OK. And then when you close it, and then you open up the original template file, let's go to the template file, PSDT folder. So PSDT, have a look at it. If you double click on it, no change has been made. So that's what I wanted to teach you. Also at the same time, if you want to make a change to the template, then you have to do this. You have to change it from PSDT back to PSD. So right click on it and rename, remove the T. Yes, I want to change it. And then see, it's back to PSD. Now any changes you make and then you press Control or Command S or go to File, Save, it will make a change to the template. So let's say you want to make a permanent change to the template and make the background a little purple. Hit OK, Control or Command S, and the permanent change has been done. Now you can turn this back into a template. So let's close this as well. Now it's purple, and now I can just right click on it, rename, and let's name it PSDT. Yes, of course, and it opens up as a new document and it's now purple. So that's how you make the templates. It also works the same with several other Adobe programs like Adobe Illustrator. So Illustrator has a file format of .ai. So if you add T to it, which will make it AIT, it will become an Adobe Illustrator template, just as PSDT. So that was pretty much it for this video. I hope this video helped you in some way or the other. And if it did, make sure to give us a like, and also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe. Ring the bell so that you, my friend, don't miss any other future tip, trick, or tutorial. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for all your support. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.